placement has been over 90% for all of our students. There's a great demand for technology innovation in our society today, and we're happy to be part of the solution to do that. One of the things we were able to complete with the state, the legislature, the governor, lieutenant governor, and the Department of Commerce is renewal of the University Engineering Initiative Act. And that's one that benefits not only our university, but the other Board of Regent universities with engineering programs. We actually exceeded the number of graduates that were anticipated 10 years ago. And with that success, and with the budgets turning around and getting better, we were very grateful that they renewed it for another 10 years. So starting next year, we'll have an additional 10 years, and we're very thankful and grateful again for that. We've had a lot of other things that have gone on really, really well for this year. One of which was to add to our facilities and to remodel the basement shop area for our biological and agricultural engineering now has a brand new shop. We remodeled our Fiedler Auditorium, all updated, new colors, a lot of purple, and a lot of good looks to it. And biomedical engineering is a newer program for us. We're just coming up for accreditation on it. The Tong Family Biomedical Laboratory. We're going to have a brand new facility this fall, thanks in part to the Tong family's support. This past year, we gave out almost $3 million total in scholarships just from the college alone. But with that, we even started a couple of new scholarships. One in particular, I point out, the Bateman Scholarship, that has enabled us to make offers to some of the high-end students that in total, over a four-year period, will be over $30,000 in scholarship per student. So we're really excited to be able to introduce and bring in our new Bateman Scholars this upcoming year.